Montenegro is a very beautiful country. It's amazing. It's amazingly beautiful. Much needs to be done and invested, but inside the European Union, obviously it would be much better. And by the way, on the other side of these mountains, there is already, only 15 kilometers away, there is already the beautiful Croatia and the European Union. And beyond this mountain is Bosnia, and in the south here Albania, in the east Serbia and Kosovo. And so here we are in this place, and it was an Austrian place until 1918, the loss of the First World War. And then 100 years it was basically neglected by the Yugoslavian authorities. Some minimal electricity was done, some village roads. The main roads were done by the Austrians. They have done some village roads. They have done a little bit in the railway connectivity, but much was inherited from the Austrian times as well. And they have done nothing in water, nothing in highways, nothing in major railway investments. Basically, they have done some military installations, but most of them were left also by Austria. When it comes all the big Porto Montenegro and Porto Novi, these are all Austrian naval installations. Now and then later taken over by the Yugoslavian army, and now they are top marinas and you're very beautiful. So what exactly Yugoslavia did, but losing one century is a mystery. Of course, not whole one century, because there was some, you know, it was only from 44 to 91 or 95 or 99 max, if you want, 2006, yeah, they were under the Serbian control. And that was, of course, very disastrous. Here, very important, in Morin is also the so-called military camp, which was part of the war with Croatia in 1999 and 1992. There were a lot of prisoners of war. They were badly mistreated. And this is one of the things Montenegro really has to regulate with Croatia in order to join the European Union, together with the Privlaka Peninsula and also this prisoners of war issue. And I'm sure there are some other issues, but make up with Croatia very fast to join the European Union very fast. This is now important, and this is my call here. I want Montenegro to join the European Union, to be fully member of the West and of the EU, and then also all the things will be much better, much easier, much faster. And that will be also then enormous additional development, and that should be in the future of Montenegro from 2024 in the European Union. Thanks a lot for listening. More to come from Pax Europiana.